Hi everyone, and welcome back to Remember What the Doctor Said. I received a few inquiries regarding ear piercing, and so I decided to have an episode on ear piercing. Ear piercing is one of the commonest procedures done. It can be done either with the ear piercing gun or a sterile pointed object made specifically for the purpose of ear piercing. I usually ask the people who come to me for ear piercing to show me the site where they would like to get their ear pierced. It is then marked with a surgical pen, measured to make sure that the site of piercing is symmetrical, that is same on both ear lobes. The earrings are placed in sterile antiseptic solution to make them sterile before piercing. The ear lobe is cleaned using an antiseptic solution, and I give a small dose of local anesthetic using a very fine needle to make that area numb so that the patient does not experience any pain during ear piercing. Once the area becomes numb, the earrings which are placed in the sterile aseptic solution is attached to the sterile pointed object that I use for ear piercing, and ear piercing is done. Because local anesthesia was given, the patients feel absolutely no pain both during piercing and for the next 2 hours after piercing. Antibiotic ointment is applied to prevent any infections. You can have a shower the same day itself and keep the area clean. I always advise people to remove or change the earrings only after 1 month after the ear piercing has been done, so that the freshly created earring hole is fully formed, including the scar formation, so that it is not difficult for them to change the earrings. Very often, if you try to remove it beforehand, you would have noticed on how the earring hole shrinks, making it difficult to change the earring. Ear piercing can be done at any age, starting from infancy and early childhood. Almost all parts of the ear can be pierced. The ear is divided anatomically into several parts, and there is no part of the ear that cannot be pierced. However, you have to be extremely cautious when you're getting your ear pierced in any place other than the lobule, which is the soft lower part of the ear. Because other than the lobule, all the other areas, there is a presence of cartilage immediately under the skin. And it is this cartilage which gives a support and shape to your ear. So when you're piercing your ear at any point other than the lobule, make sure it is done by an expert, and make sure that the instruments used for the same are sterile and all aseptic precautions are taken before piercing, because an infection can lead to an infection of the skin as well as the cartilage, which can bring about certain changes in the shape or size of the cartilage, and it is very difficult to treat. What do you do if you develop an ear infection? First thing is to remove the earring from the infected ear. The ear infections at the site of ear piercing usually starts off with redness and pain, and if the earring is not removed, it proceeds further to develop pus and further pain, and can even develop fever with that. The infection becomes so severe. So once you feel you are developing a redness or pain at the site of the ear piercing, number one, remove the earring. Apply antiseptic ointments to the site. Take painkillers if you find the pain is increasing. Even with these measures, if you think the pain is not coming down or things are getting worse, always show your doctor. Sometimes the infection becomes so severe that the earring is buried within the ear lobule and it becomes very difficult for you to remove it. In such a situation, always show the doctor. He will be able to remove it under local anesthesia, which causes absolutely no pain. Ear piercing can be done both using a gunshot method as well as sterile pointers. Always make sure that strict aseptic methods are followed while getting your ear pierced, at the earliest sign of infection, remove the earring and follow the steps I mentioned earlier. And if you feel that the infection is not getting controlled by these measures, always consult your doctor. Remember what the doctor said. Thank you. Bye.